Hello viewers, we started the topic complex permanent tissue phloem in last lecture and covered the first component, that is sieve elements. Today we will discuss the other components of the phloem. Second one is companion cell. Companion cell are the thin walled elongated cells and specialized parenchymata cells which are associated with the sieve elements, that act like a friend of sieve elements. That's why these are known as the companion cells. These are the living cells having full of cytoplasm and the prominent nucleus. They are connected with the sieve tube. Har ek sieve tube ke saath mein ek companion cell present hogi. And these companion cells are connected with the sieve tube with the help of pits that are found in the lateral walls of the sieve tube elements and the companion cells. Through these pits, cytoplasmic connections are maintained between these sieve tube elements and companion cells. These cells are very helpful in maintaining the pressure gradient in the sieve tubes during the transport. And these cells have the nuclei. So, nucleus of the companion cells serve for the nuclei of the sieve tube, because the sieve tubes mature sieve tubes don't have the nucleus. So, जो भी nucleus के functions है वो सारे के सारे companion cells करेगी sieve tube elements के लिए. Companion cells are present only in the angiosperms and are present in the gymnosperms and pteridophytes. Pteridophytes and gymnosperms में जो other type की cells present होती हैं, क्योंकि वहाँ पे sieve cells present है और sieve cells के साथ other cells present होती हैं associations के लिए, that are termed as the albuminous cells. This is the structure of the companion cells. These are the lateral walls, lateral pores with the help of which these are connected with the sieve tube cells. These have the other prominent organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, and these have the prominent nucleus and full of cytoplasm and a central large vacuole present in it. Main function of the companion cell is to provide help to the sieve tube cell during the transport. So, during the transport, it maintains the pressure gradient in the sieve tube cells. It controls the passes of the materials and provide energy to the sieve tube cells for performing loading and unloading, assimilate during the transport of the solutes. Third component is phloem parenchyma. Phloem parenchyma are the living cells and having the dense cytoplasm, nucleus and cell very thin cell walls. Cell of the phloem parenchyma are elongated, having the pointing ends or may be cylindrical. They may be subspherical or polyhedral in the shape. Phloem parenchyma are main function is storage of the organic food or other some substances like resins, tannins, mucilaginous and latex, etc. Phloem parenchyma are sometimes also known as the transfer cells, because these help in the lateral conduction of the food. So, the border parenchymatous cells hoti hai, that are present near the jo finest branches, hoti hai, terminations of sieve tube cells, ke, leaf ke jo winlets, unme, wahan pe ye lateral conduction, ka, lateral transport of food mein help karenge. Phloem parenchyma are absent in the monocots. Fourth component is phloem fibers. This is the only sclerenchymatous cells present in the phloem. Otherwise, jo tino ki tino wo living cells hain. So, this is present in both primary and secondary phloem and commonly known as the bast fibers. These are the elongated cell with maybe they may be lignified as in hemp or maybe non-lignified as in linium, having only the simple pits. Fibers may be septate or non-septate. They are sportive and conductive cell of the phloem and provide strength to the stem. On the basis of their texture, these are divided into two categories. Soft fibers, these are classified as the soft fibers and are flexible. This is the structure of the parenchyma, phloem parenchyma, and these are the structure of the phloem fibers. Types of phloem. On the basis of development, there are two types of phloem, primary phloem and secondary phloem. Primary phloem, that is arise from the procambial cell, and secondary phloem, that is arise from the vascular cambium. Primary phloem is divided into टू प्रोटोफ्लोएम एंड मेटाफ्लोएम. प्रोटोफ्लोएम में जो सीव ट्यूब मेंबर्स हैं वहां पे कंपेनियन सेल प्रेजेंट नहीं होगी, क्योंकि प्रोटोफ्लोएम में सीव ट्यूब में न्यूक्लियस प्रेजेंट होगा ऑलरेडी, तो वो अपना जो सारा वर्क है वो सेल्फ सफिशिएंट है, कर सकते हैं, तो वहां पे कंपेनियन सेल्स की जरूरत ही नहीं होगी, इसलिए वहां पे कंपेनियन सेल्स प्रेजेंट नहीं होंगे. सीव ट्यूब्स का जो फंक्शन है फॉर ए बहुत ही सीव ट्यूब्स जो है प्रोटोफ्लोएम में बहुत कम टाइम के लिए फंक्शन करती है, बिकॉज अर्ली मेटाफ्लोएम डेवलप होगा और उसकी वजह से ये क्या है क्रस्ड हो जाएंगे ड्यू टू सराउंडिंग प्रेशर ऑफ द मेटाफ्लोएम. सो मेटाफ्लोएम इसमें लार्जर टाइम के लिए सर्वाइव करेगा और लॉन्गर टाइम के लिए सर्वाइव करने वाला टिश्यू है. फाइबर्स आर एबसेंट इन द डाइकोटिलेडंस, वेयर एज इन मोनोकोटिलेडंस और हर्बेसियस डाइकोट्स और वहां पे जो फ्लोएम पैरेन्काइमा है दैट इज एबसेंट. सेकेंडरी फ्लोएम, टू टाइप के सिस्टम ऑफ अरेंजमेंट होता है सेकेंडरी फ्लोएम में. वन इन एक्सियल, जिसमें जो सीव दैट प्रोड्यूस द सीव ट्यूब एलिमेंट्स, फ्लोएम पैरेन्काइमा एंड फ्लोएम फाइबर्स. ट्रांसवर्स सिस्टम दैट इज प्रोड्यूसिंग द रे पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स. दिस इज द ट्रांसवर्स स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फ्लोएम एलिमेंट्स एंड दिस इज द लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फ्लोएम एलिमेंट्स. फर्स्ट इज द सीव ट्यूब, सीव ट्यूब कंटेनिंग विद द associated with companion cells. This is the parenchymatous cells and the parenchymatous cells are living cells having the nucleus. This companion cells also possesses the nucleus and dense cytoplasm. These are the sieve plates with sieve pores in the sieve tube elements. This is the longitudinal structure. Here it's showing the companion cell along with the sieve tube cells. These are the sieve tubes connected with each other with the help of a pores present in the sieve plates. These are the parenchymatous cells with dense cytoplasm and nucleus, and these are the phloem fibers. Now, difference between primary phloem and secondary phloem. These are to be about like primary xylem and secondary xylem. Primary phloem originates from the apical meristem or procambium of apical meristem. These secondary phloem arise from the vascular cambium. In the primary phloem, the first form protophloem and then the metaphloem. But here is no such type of differentiation is found in protophloem and metaphloem in the secondary phloem. Phloem fibers are found in the outer part of the phloem. यहाँ पे जो phloem fibers हैं वो in between the phloem parenchymatous cells present होंगे. Sieve tubes usually longer with the narrow lumen, but here the sieve tube की जो length है that is shorter, but their जो lumen है that is increased. Phloem parenchyma is very poorly developed in the primary phloem. Here the phloem parenchyma is fully developed and act as a storage for the food materials. Sclerites are normally absent in this. Sclerites are found only in the secondary phloem. Medullary rays are found in this region and these are arise from the activity of apical meristem during primary phloem. Here the medullary rays arise and these are developed from the reinitial of the cambium. Medullary rays are mainly homocellular, but in case of the secondary phloem, medullary rays are homocellular or maybe heterocellular. During the primary phloem formation, callose formation around the sieve pore is most of the cases may absent hogi, but in case of the secondary phloem, callose formation is abundant. So this is all about the complex permanent tissue. Thanks.